Good evening, pretty people, and welcome to Waking Up Free right here in the great old state of Dallas, Texas. Tonight, I am coming at you with another, and that is What's for Dinner. Tonight, I am keeping it simple and to the point and quick because I have been in the kitchen all day long canning, and now I'm going to go ahead and whip this dinner out, get my family served, and then take myself a break and a bath. Yeah. So the ingredients are very simple that we'll need. We've got some ground beef here. I like to use the ratio 80-20. A little bit of Trinity, that's your onion, bell pepper, celery, and of course I kicked that up with a little bit of garlic. I actually use a Mirepoix brand, so I guess it's not quite just Trinity because once you add the carrot, it does become a Mirepoix. So anyway, yes, a little bit of diced carrot, a little bit of onion, I said that already. I was looking at the garlic and said something else. Garlic, a little bit of brown sugar, a couple of eggs. We got some roasted broccoli that I will be roasting in just a minute. Mashed potatoes, and I keep saying, darn, whatever. Just get over it. I'm not about to edit that because I'm way too far into this thing. Couple of eggs to bind that whole thing together. A little bit of breadcrumbs, got some tomato paste and some this right here in the can. It's called crushed tomatoes. That's what it is right here in this can. Oh, long day, people. Long, long day. A little bit of anchovy paste. I like to go ahead and make my topping for my meatloaf sauce. Homemade. I don't use the jar kind of thing, so I make it myself. And I kick it up a little bit with that anchovy paste because you can tell that there's something in it, but you don't really know what it is. So I don't normally blurt that out because, you know, the children can get a little bit iffy on that, but they don't know what's in there and they eat it anyway. And a little bit of Worcestershire sauce, my spices here, salt, black pepper, onion powder, garlic powder. You know the drill. You've been watching me for a minute. And so I'm going to go ahead and get this started. I've got my pots on the stove ready to go. So I'm going to go ahead and, head over that way and see what's going on. But before I do that, I'm going to make Robert's tea. So let me go ahead and get that dropped. I got a pot of water going here. Turn that up. My pans seem to be nice and hot. So the first thing I'm going to do is actually before I combine my meat mixture, I saute my vegetables up a little bit first and then I add them to the mixture so that everything is nice and combined at the same even temperature. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, starting that off with a tad bit of vegetable oil. So I'm going to go ahead and drop in about a good 2 to 3 tablespoons, depending on what the vegetables need. That's what we're gonna go with. And then about a pat or two of butter, just to even that fat ratio out. Okay. And I'm gonna saute my carrots in here just a bit first. I'm gonna add them all. That's about actually a cup of carrots. So I'm gonna go ahead and let those work their magic for just a minute. And then I'm gonna go ahead and dice up my potatoes because I wanna go ahead and drop those out really soon. Okay, here we go. So how y'all doing out there this evening? Did y'all catch Game of Thrones last night? Are y'all any Game of Thrones fans out there? Oh my gosh. The show is getting good. Really good. Anyway, back to this dinner before I went off on my whole Game of Thrones kick. Since Walking Dead is over, well actually I go between the two because you know they come on at different times of year, but everybody has their show, and those two are my it shows. So anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and dice up my potatoes. I like to use Yukon Golds. You can use whatever you like. Russets are fine. Red potatoes, they don't necessarily mash up as well to my liking. I find them to be a little bit tough, and they take forever to cook. And when you're in the kitchen trying to feed a family of five, you're not trying to be there all day. So I like to get this done quickly as I can. And also the Yukon Gold potatoes, they are nice and buttery, so you don't have to add a lot of butter. although that never stops me from adding an extra stick, maybe three. So I'm gonna go ahead and dice these up real quick. And then this will come together real soon because a lot of it, beyond the potatoes, it cooks off in the oven, and that way you can go and do something else, like watch YouTube videos. Y'all like that? I did. So that's actually, for a family of five, I do about six medium to large size. And that usually serves pretty much one night, maybe two. I always keep something on hand, although I'm not a big fan of leftovers. My husband, he doesn't have a problem with that at all. He'll eat anything that I prepare, although what smart man wouldn't? But no, he's real good about that. He usually takes it for his lunch. Okay, they've already been washed and cleaned, so I'm gonna go ahead and drop them into my pot of water here. There we go. And then I'm gonna add a little bit of salt to go ahead, because you know, potatoes take forever to season, and the best way to season your potatoes and your pasta is to season the water. So yeah, it does look like I'm adding it in a generous amount, and that's actually because I am, because it takes so much to season. So back to our carrots. Now I don't want them to be completely broken down, so sauteing there is just about what I need. And then I'm going to use half of them in my actual meatloaf itself, and then the other half actually for the sauce, but I'm actually going to cook it just once. And then the ones that go in my actual meatloaf itself, I do those half raw, half not. So it still has a slight crunch, but then slightly cooked as well. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and combine that into one bowl, save myself a couple of trips. I don't need that extra work. And I'm gonna go ahead and drop my celery. And that's actually about maybe a little more than half a cup, but not quite 3/4. Okay. And my garlic will go in last. So now I'm going to go ahead and add a little bit of salt so that they can start sweating and become translucent. Again, I'm not cooking it completely. I'm just getting them just below translucent. And pepper. I like to freshly grind my pepper. I haven't gone to the store. I actually have a bigger pepper mill, but this will work until I make my way down to the grocery store. I try not to go shopping too often, not more than once a month, except for dairy. And how do I get by shopping only once a month? Because I'm a couponer, that's why. So I don't need to. Oh, I don't need a pepper. Actually, I'll wait on that. Okay, so while that's doing its thing, I think what I'll do is start on my broccoli, because I'm going to do some roasted broccoli. Okay. So your vegetables will start looking something like this. So I'm going to leave these here on the back burner for just a minute. Let my potatoes do their thing. Robert's tea seemed to be just fine.
So now I'm going to start all my broccoli. I've already washed it, so now I am going to get it all nice and sliced and diced. And ready for roasting. I just love when the summer gets here, spring and summer, because then you have all the fresh fruits and vegetables that are coming into season. And then you get to eat more from the earth. There's nothing wrong with frozen vegetables. I use them myself too quite often when I can't get it fresh, or maybe I just don't have the time to sit and do what I'm doing now. But normally I pretty much try to do it as often as I can. But buy my produce fresh. You know, here locally, we have a place called Urban Acres, and that's a place locally where you can get, it's like a membership kind of thing where you pay like a monthly fee, and you get fresh, organic vegetables. There's a place where you can go and pick it up. You can choose your location depending on your city, but you get a wide variety of different produce at, you know, I think for our rate, since we're a family of five, I think we pay like $60, maybe $70 a month. But it was pretty good, you know, because it kept you trying new things. And so you never knew what you were going to get. You couldn't pick and choose. But if you are in the DFW area, it's called Urban Acres. And it's really fun. It's like a little co-op kind of thing. And you get your fresh produce there, which we've come to really enjoy that. And it keeps you out of the grocery store. I don't mind shopping, but I hate going. I guess hate is a strong word. I strongly dislike going weekly. But then if you want your produce and your vegetables fresh, you have to go weekly. So I'm basically just doing a rough chop since they are going to be roasted. They can be a little bit more rustic, you know. They don't have to always be perfect.
This is a butcher block, less five sit there. And I am going to let those cool for about 5 minutes before I add them to my meat mixture. Although my meat mixture is room temperature, I'm still gonna let those cool. So anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and go with the rest of my ingredients, which is a little bit of Worcestershire sauce, or a lot of Worcestershire sauce. That's actually about a tablespoon. And salt and pepper. Now, because I'm going to be adding more seasoning to my sauce, I don't need a whole lot in my meat, but I do want to add a fair amount. That should be about enough. Onion powder, garlic powder, about 2 to 3 teaspoons, or more if you like it. I like to taste my spices. Okay. And then, and instead of adding like ketchup or anything like that, I'm going to do tomato paste. So I use Hunt's, that's my favorite, so. And then some crushed tomatoes. Red Gold's are really good. You can find these at, of course, you know, Walmart, you know, or any other place you shop. Although I found that Walmart actually has the best price. I found them for as low as, I think, 29 cents a can. So you certainly can't beat that. The stick. I so need a new can opener. I keep saying that. About a tablespoon. Whoa, I'm sorry, that was loud. I didn't mean to do that to y'all. And then about 3 tablespoons of crushed tomatoes. That way I have that tomatoey feel without that ketchup. Now I'm also going to go ahead and crack in a couple of eggs. Okay. All right. Now I'm going to
mash it all together.
Acts as a binder, and then I'm going to go back in with some breadcrumbs as well to help bind it. Teaspoons of that. Okay. Oh, I need to get my pan ready. I actually roast mine on a cookie sheet. So to keep it from sticking, I'm going to go ahead and spray that in the pan. Italian breadcrumbs. This is actually about maybe 3/4 of a cup. You can leave that out if you want. I just like the flavor. And it also, again, helps to bind it. So. I'm going to gently mix this one in where everything flies out of my bowl. I probably should have used that bowl right there, but then it wouldn't have fit my broccoli. All Now, when you mix it, you want to be sure not to over, you don't want to under mix, but you also don't want to over mix, because over mixing can cause your meat to become tight. Have you ever tasted a dry, tasteless meatloaf? Chances are it was over mixed. Or they're just bad cooks and they're just not like me. That's what it is. Okay, so that's nicely combined and incorporated. So now I'm going to shape it in a loop. I don't like to use a loaf pan. I know a lot of people do that, but the reason that I don't is because all of the fat sort of pools together and then sits atop that pan. I don't like the way it looks like that. Squeeze in about a little less than a tablespoon, but not quite a teaspoon. I mean, a little more than a teaspoon, but not quite a tablespoon. Maybe I'll squeeze it in. We'll see. These little caps. Anchovy paste to a tomato product gives a very unique flavor, so I love that. All gives just that extra zip, but no one can really tell what it is. Except for everybody on YouTube now, right? Oh my gosh, the horror! Okay, so when that's fully incorporated, it's gonna look something like this. Now it's time for our tomato paste. Go ahead and get some texture and some body. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and let that caramelize just a bit. I'm gonna come back and re-season now. Whoa, that stove is hot. As if I expected it to be cold. Let's check on our butter. Yep, our butter's about right. Actually, you know what? I think I'm going to leave out the salt because the anchovy paste is salty. So I'm just going to go ahead and go with some pepper. A dash of Worcestershire sauce and my tomato, crushed tomatoes. And the rest of my crushed tomatoes. That's about 3/4 cup. To balance out the savory taste of the anchovies and the tomatoes, I'm going to add a touch of brown sugar. That's a little bit less than a teaspoon. A tablespoon. So we'll balance out the savory with a little bit of sweet. Everything incorporated. It's going to look something like this. So I'm going to go ahead and turn that down. I think I already said that, but there we go. Potatoes are, let me see if those are fork tender. Hang on. Not quite, maybe another 5 or 7 minutes. Okay, now, I'm going to go ahead and toss in my broccoli. That's going to take a little bit. And my Hawaiian rolls. I love these. I don't see any point in baking when you can buy this delicious goodness. Okay. And since I've already buttered my pan here, I'm just going to kind of wiggle that in a little bit. Butter the tops. And the cast iron just does something to it. It comes just nice and brown on the bottom. has that nice little crunch. Rolls there for a second. I'm actually looking for, what am I looking for? Herb. That's what I'm looking for. Okay. Okay. This is the blend my mother-in-law sent me, so I'm going to use it until it's all gone. Gonna put a sprinkle, a little bit of herbs on top, a little bit of buttery herb magic for my bread. Just give it that extra touch of homemade, but not really. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and set this aside, and I shall return. Okay, y'all, it's time for us to check on our potatoes and our meat. Our broccoli, not quite, a little more than half, well, not quite half. Okay, I'm gonna drain it off a bit. Wouldn't that be funny if it fell into the sink? Okay, now for our gravy. Meat is just about a little more than halfway done. That little bit I'm going to save for the side, that'll make a really good little sandwich. Robert likes meatloaf sandwiches, so I'll save the rest of that gravy for that. And we'll pop that back in the oven. Now for our potatoes, I'm going to drain those off real quick. And then they are a little more than halfway done, but not quite done. So what I'm going to do is add my butter, salt, and pepper. I'm going to be a little bit sparing with the salt because I'm going to add, you know, I do add milk and butter to it as well, but to cut down on the milk, since I'm adding butter and milk, it's a high fat content, I slim it down with just some chicken stock. So I still get the flavor without all the extra fat. And then that's going to simmer and finish cooking. That was a little more than 3/4 cup. And then my butter. That was a little less than 3/4 stick. If I need to add more, I'll come back and do it. Let's see. I'm gonna turn that back up to medium heat, and then I'll be right back at y'all.
Okay, pretty people, now it's time for this whole show to get started. I think everything is coming together. Enjoy this. Always remember to click that subscribe button right here, right there. I can't remember where it is, but